Hello, grade 9 students. So this is Ma'am Malieri. So last time we've discussed or we've talked about the music of Freemasons in medieval period. So dahil yun yung nasa kapaloob sa ating module number 1. So during this time, we'll be discussing the music of Baroque period. So this is module 2 of music. Okay, so music of Baroque period ranges from 1685 to 1750s. The word Baroque is derived from the Portuguese word Barroco, which means pearl of irregular shape. During this time, the arts highlighted grandiose and elaborate ornamentation. These were clearly seen in the music composition created by Baroque composers. So later on, you'll be discussing and I will be showing you some of their compositions during Baroque period. A lot of musical terms during Baroque era are still being used today. What are the characteristics of the Baroque? What are the characteristics of music during the Baroque period? So melody sounds elaborate and ornamental. Melodies are not easy to sing or remember. Homophonic. Music genres, operas, oratorios, suites, toccatas, concerto grosso, and fugue. Harpsichord and organ are the keyboard instruments that are commonly used. New forms, binary, AB. Okay, so music genre of the Baroque period. Concerto. It is an orchestral music that employs a solo instrument accompanied by an orchestra. Solo instrument. So ito siya. Ito yung solo natin. Ito yung harpsichord natin. That is being accompanied by the whole orchestra. Yan, yung mga stringed instrument natin. Ito siya. Ito yung pinaka-solo natin. So once again, that is concerto. Now let us move on to the second one. Concerto grosso. Concerto grosso is an orchestral music composed of small group solo instruments, concertino, and the whole orchestra, the whole orchestra we call the tutti. So this is the concertino. Itong concertino, small group of soloists. Ayan, ito sila. Ito sila nasa part na to. And being accompanied by the whole orchestra, which is the tutti ito. Ito sila. Yung buong orchestra. So the difference between concerto and concerto grosso. Sa concerto, let's go back. Ito, sa concerto, meron tayong isang star dito. When we say star, siya yung solo instrument natin, accompanied by the whole orchestra. While dito, sa concerto grosso, isang group of soloists na mga small instruments being accompanied by the whole orchestra. Now, let us move on to our third genre, which is the fugue. It is a contrapuntal piece. So, mahirap siyang explain, so I will be showing it to you na lang. So, ito po siya. Pakitignan yung animation. Animation siya ng composition ni Johann Sebastian Bach, Toccata and Fugue in D minor. Kindly look at the animation.
Thank you.
Okay, so di ba nga kapag merong piano, may ba meron tayong tinatawag na lower octave and higher octave. So ito yung nire-represent niya. 'Di ba? Pag sa kamay natin nagpa-piano tayo, ito isa sa mataas, yung isa para sa mababa. So ito yung nire-represent niya. Ng animation na to, ano ba yung galaw ng kamay, ano ba yung galaw ng mga nota, ano ba yung galaw ng nasa kanan, ano ba yung galaw ng nasa kaliwa. So kaya siya tinawag na contrapuntal piece. Okay, so now let us move on to the next one. Oratorio. So oratorio is a type of musical narration without costume or action. So paano yung without costume or action? So nagna-narrate, basically nagna-narrate siya ng isang story. Nagna-narrate ng isang story tong musicians na ginagawa lang nila sa pamamagitan ng pagkanta. Siyempre, meron tayong musical accompaniment. So paano to? Ganito po siya. Okay, so that is oratorio. So, yung ginawa nila, ninanarrate nila yung pagkabuhay ni Jesus Christ kasi this is Mass by Bach again, na ninanarrate nila kung paano ba ipinanganak si Jesus Christ. Usually, ginagawa to during magpapasko. Yung oratorio na to. So, walang costume, walang action. It's more on telling the story or narrating the story through singing and through playing instruments. So, that is oratorio. Okay. So, for the last genre, we have here the choral. So, it is a harmonized version of hymnal tunes. So, different kinds of voices, different ranges of voices. So, technically, what we know about choral is meron tayong four different kinds of voices. So, meron tayo sa babae, then meron tayo sa lalaki. So, we have alto soprano for the girls, and then meron tayong bass, and what else is sa lalaki? And tenor sa lalaki. So ito siya. This is an example of choral. And this is by Bach. Mass in G minor.
Thank you.
So that is choral. Now let us move on to the famous composers of the Baroque period. So we have here Johann Sebastian Bach. He is known for instrumental and vocal compositions, as mostly renowned as the organist. His famous works includes Mass in B minor, Cantata 288, Concerto Grosso, and Fugue in G minor. Yung Fugue in G minor, yung fugue na binigay ko example kanina, yun yung composition ni Johann Sebastian Bach. So, ayan siya. So, one of his composition is entitled Air. So, ito po siya. Overture, Orchestra Suite number 3. Johann Sebastian Bach. So, nakakasabi sa nabasa ko, nakaka-relax daw siya. At saka, kapag pinakinggan daw ng mga buntis, medyo nadidevelop daw yung skills ng mga bata when it comes to music. So, nakaka-develop siya ng brain development ng mga baby sa loob ng child. Relaxing din daw. Okay, so now let us move on to our next composer. So, for the next composer, we have here Antonio Vivaldi. He is a violin virtuoso. Nicknamed the Red Priest because of his red hair, regarded as one of the greatest composers of the Baroque period. So his famous works are Four Seasons, Spring, Summer, Autumn, and Winter. So dito siya talaga nakilala sa Four Seasons niya. So ano ba yung Four Seasons na to? Kaya siya tinawag na Four Seasons, yun nga, based dun sa mga seasons natin. So we have spring, summer, autumn, and winter. So bawat isang season, meron siyang kaakibat na composition dito. So let us hear from Antonio Vivaldi. Okay, so this one is the Four Seasons, summer. First movement, Allegro non molto. So that is Summer by Antonio Vivaldi. So kung papakinggan nyo siyang mabuti, maririnig nyo yung ang violin na ginamit nila no, na naging outstand dun sa mismong composition. Okay, now let us move on to the second season. So yung next natin is Winter. Largo. Pag sinabi natin Largo, medyo mabilis siya. So that is Winter by Antonio Vivaldi. Now let us move on to the next season. So we have here the Autumn. Now let us move on to the last season. So for the last season, we have here the Spring. That is Spring by Antonio Vivaldi. So ako, most favorite ko itong last part, yung Spring, kasi medyo upbeat na siya. No? So now let us move on to our next composer. So our next composer is George Frideric Handel. I don't know if I'm saying the name correct, but yun yung alam ko. He is known for his operas, oratorios, and organ concertos, influenced by Italian Baroque and German choral tradition. His most famous work is The Messiah. So, believe me or not, familiar kayo dito at alam nyo to. So, this is the chorus of The Messiah. It is entitled Alleluia. Okay, so that is Messiah, Alleluia by George Frideric Handel. So yung sinasabi natin kanina na napaka-ornamented daw yung music ng Baroque, totoo siya, di ba? So kung mapapansin nyo, palaging full pack yung instruments natin, full pack yung tunog, tsaka mga delikado siya, delicate yung mga nota natin. So paano natin malalaman delikado? So kung by bare listening lang, maririnig nyo naman na napakahirap niyang kantahin at napakaraming elemento na isinasama doon sa kanilang mga compositions. So with that, I hope you learned something new. So again, so that is the music of the Baroque period. So once again, I'm Ma'am Janice Teen and see you po sa susunod.